Greetings. If you call yourself Muslim, I challenge you to actually question the Quran's divinity. I was preparing a video, and in the video I needed to reference where the Quran forbids asking questions. So I looked up the words, "Don't ask questions," from the Quran and found the following. Surah 5:101. O you who believe, ask not questions about things which, if made plain to you, may cause you trouble. But if you ask about things when the Quran is being revealed, they will be made plain to you. Allah will forgive those, for Allah is oft forgiving, most forbearing. Now I've only highlighted the first sentence. I'll address it first, then examine the context, which has fascinating implications. Simply stated, Muslims are told to not ask questions about things. What things, it is fair to ask? Things that, if made plain to you, might cause trouble. Right off the bat, we observe this means some things are not plain. That is logically self-evident. Some things are not plain. In spite of the Quran's claim, it is clear, meaning plain. So, if these things that are admittedly unclear are in the Quran, it causes a problem. A big problem. Because the Quran claims in many places it is clear. And while it is gradually revealed, this surah now proves that which was already revealed was not clear up to this point. This is what requires the questions to be asked. But perhaps Muhammad was shooting from the hip about things not addressed by his Quran because of his lack of need or lack of knowledge. Certainly, Muhammad knew nothing of aerodynamics or hydroponics or gravitational forces and escape velocity. But then, neither did his slaves and submissives, who probably knew less than Muhammad. If made plain to you, may cause you trouble. If Muhammad tried to explain, those obedient to him would be troubled. I decided to take a look at other translations of the Arabic word meaning troubled. Might cause you hardship. Would trouble you. Would raise anger in you. Would only become burdensome for you. Each of those has a subtly different meaning and implication. Do not ask about such things as would worry you if they were shown to you. This is actually very different in implication than the other translations. Translated this way, it is even vaguely reminiscent of Jesus saying to not worry about the future in particular. If made plain to you, may cause you trouble. Now, the aspect of this I actually find distressing is the clear presence of confusion. Things are known to Muhammad's followers, but they are not plain. So they are asking, and they are essentially told, sit down and shut up. Don't ask. Percolate on that for a few minutes as you contemplate whether Islam is a religion that provides actual answers to the problems of life. How can it, when even with Muhammad alive to answer, he forbid asking challenging questions? But you will find the rest of the ayat has an even more interesting implication. But if you ask about things when the Quran is being revealed, they will be made plain to you. Let that sink in. But if you ask when the Quran is being revealed, while it is still being revealed. I find the usage of the word revealed to be a bit cynical. First, notice the word being is a time word, meaning the present tense. The Quran has been started, but is not complete. A committed submissive to Muhammad would claim, no, Allah has already finished it. It is eternal. The claim would be, it is just not completely revealed yet. But what possible difference can it make if you ask as the Quran is still being revealed. Remember, the command is don't ask about things already revealed. Wait until it is being revealed. O you who believe, ask not questions about things which, if made plain to you, may cause you trouble. But if you ask about things when the Quran is being revealed, they will be made plain to you. I admit, this is about like nailing jello to a wall. This could refer to issues the Quran will never address, like abortion or gravity or tawheed, a word which never appears in the Quran. But if you ask about things when the Quran is being revealed, they will be made plain to you. But if you ask when the Quran is being revealed, why? What possible difference can it make if you ask as the Quran is still being revealed? Well, maybe it makes a difference in the order of revelation. Here, this piece I would have revealed later answers your burning question right now. But worse, it implies additions to the eternal Quran could still be made. I, Allah, did not already think about that. So let's add Surah 39:46 to answer this new perplexing question. If you ask a question while I'm still inventing the Quran, I can make up an answer and include it in the Quran with that day's revelation. Can you see how self-serving this is? Allah will forgive those. And he's talking about the questions that are being asked while the Quran is being revealed. Allah will forgive those, for Allah is oft forgiving, most forbearing. This too is ambiguous. Is Allah forgiving the question being asked? He often forgives such questions, but not always. Oft forgiving is a form of often forgiving, but not always. So Allah being oft forgiving means you are still in a crapshoot. I wonder if that is because it gives Allah a chance to fix his errors before going to print. Seriously, don't ask questions. But hey, if you ask questions before I finish writing this book, I may forgive that, because I can fix the confusing text that confused you. And then, here comes the big scary hammer of reinforcement. Please think about this scenario with me. Consider uninformed or ignorant people. This could be children, or uninformed liberals who ignorantly assume lies about other people. There may need to be a group decision, and a few are determined to do their own thing. Someone, trying to dissuade them, will put forth a counter story that simply attacks the idea of the hard-headed. It might be to make up a story. I know someone who tried that and they lost a finger, or lost a leg, or died, or disappeared, or were never heard from again. Attack the idea, then claim it results in a catastrophe, all invented on the spot with no evidence. You might not think it, but asking questions is just such risky business. Surah 5:102. Some people before you did ask such questions, and on that account lost their faith. Another translation. People before your time have indeed asked such questions, and in result thereof have come to deny the truth. You see, I told you, asking questions will make you leave my religion. Don't ask questions, or you'll end up like them. If only those people had asked their warners before their warners had finished their Qurans. I'm sorry, but every time I sit down and begin to read what the Quran actually says, I find nonsense and cannot help but point it out for what it is. Nonsense. If you call yourself Muslim, I challenge you to actually question the Quran's divinity. The argument in Surah 5, 101 and 102 is that of a school child telling a lie to manipulate you. If Islam cannot answer and forbids you from asking real, honest, legitimate questions, it is a fraud that should be abandoned for that reason alone. If you call yourself Muslim, I believe you are sincere and you are committed to the thing your father and mother told you was the truth. You owe it to God your Creator to ask Him, the God of Abraham, any and every question. Islam is a false path and blinds you with commands to keep you uninformed. Ask your questions and let Islam shake in fear. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.